Hi students, welcome in our science section, chapter number 3, part 3, cleaning food. In previous part, we have learned about separation of insoluble solids from liquids by sedimentation, decantation, filtration, evaporation, condensation and distillation method. Now in this part, you are learning about separation of liquid from mixture of immiscible liquids. Separation of liquid from immiscible liquid. Oil does not dissolve in water. Oil and water are immiscible liquids. Oil floats on water. It can be separated from water using a separating funnel. Means student, you understand? Immiscible liquids means those liquids which are not mixed with each other. Then here given example of oil and water. These two immiscible liquids, oil float on water, it can be separated from water using a separating funnel. In given diagram shown separating funnel, first layer is kerosene oil and second layer is water, and that stopcock, with the help of that stopcock you are taking water down. For how you are doing this activity? Pour a mixture of oil and water in a separating funnel. Leave it undisturbed for some time. You will be see a clear layer of oil over the water. Turn the stopper of the separating funnel open and allow the water to flow out into the beaker. Placed below it, stop the flow as soon as the layer of oil reaches the stopper. Means you understand how to do this activity? First you take the mixture of oil and water and few minutes wait for two layers is form. And when two layers form, then turn on the stop clock and only first layer means water layer you take in the beaker. Separation of mixture by using more than one method. Where you obtain a single method of separation is not sufficient to separate the different components in a mixture. Then two or more methods of separation are used one after another. Means any mixture is happen there and you are using only one single method, then it is not separated for each other. Then that time what you are doing? There you are using different methods, means more than two methods. For example, here given ways to separate salt and sand. Suppose salt and sand is mix each other, then what you are doing? First you are making the solution of salt and water. Then afterwards you are that soluble, salt is soluble in the water but sand is not soluble in the water. Then with the help of filtration paper, you are filter that solution. And after the solution, means water and salt, which is one type of solution that coming down in the beaker. Then you also want to separate salt also from water. Sand is separated with the help of filtration paper. And now you want to separate the salt from water. Then which process you are doing? Evaporation. Means here you are using first is a making solution, second method you are using filtration, and third method you are using evaporation. Means here you are using more than two methods for separate the salt and sand. Friend, you know water is a universal solvent. Then why water is called a universal solvent? Water is called a universal solvent because it can dissolve many things in it. When a substance is dissolved in water, it forms a solution. Means don't you understand? So many things are dissolved in the water, and when you are dissolve any substance in water, then you got the solution. Means the substance that dissolve is called a solute. Substance that dissolve is called a solute, and the substance in which the solute dissolve is called a solvent. The resulting mixture is called a solution. For example, here given sugar, water and sugar solution. Then sugar is a solute. Why solute? Because sugar dissolves in the water. And where sugar is dissolved? In the water. Means water is a solvent. And when this sugar is dissolved in a solvent, means water, then form sugar solution. Understand this point? Means solute is a solid part, solvent is a liquid part and two mixes each other when dissolved, you got the solution. You must have, means next our point is saturated solution. How you got the saturated solution? You must have experienced that if you keep adding salt to a glass of water, after some time no more salt can dissolve in the water. Any more salt added is left undissolved at the bottom of the glass. This is because the solution has become saturated, a solution in which no more solid can be dissolved at a given temperature is called a saturated solution. However, more solid can be dissolved in a saturated solution than by heating. In student, you understand, you take a 1 glass of water and take salt. First, you 1 tablespoon salt is add and mix it properly, it is dissolved. Then second add, it is dissolved. Third add, it is dissolved. Fourth add, it is dissolved. But one condition is coming, when you are adding the salt, it is not dissolved in that water, means that solution is called as a unsaturated solution, means that salt is remain as it is, then you called this solution is unsaturated solution. Means what is the definition of saturated solution? A solution in which no more solute can be dissolved at a given temperature is called a saturated solution. And when this salt is dissolved, when you heat that saturated solution, then that salt become to start a dissolve. Means student, in this point, you are, means in this part, you are complete our third lesson, cleaning of food. In cleaning of food, you are learned need for separation of substance from a mixture, different methods of a separation, and water is a universal solvent. In this way, today, in this section, we have complete our third lesson. You understand this? Thank you.